Good morning, students. Today we are going to see two illustrations, 17 and 18. Up to 16 we have completed. 17 and 18, it is little different. We need to prepare trading and profit and loss account and balance sheet. That means the final accounts. For this purpose only, we have learned from that illustration 10 to 16. Many information we have found out. What are the credit sales from the debtors account, then credit purchases from the creditors account. For that creditors account, we need bills payable. So that we have calculated. Then to find out the credit sales, we need to see the bills receivable. So that account, all these accounts we have prepared, and we have found out some missing items. From this missing items, we can prepare the trading and profit and loss account and balance sheet. That we will see today two problems, and tomorrow again the next two problems. With that we will end this chapter. Okay, let me read the question now. From the following details of Abdul, who maintains incomplete records, prepare trading and profit and loss account for the year ended 31st March 2018 and a balance sheet as on that date. Particulars given: opening, closing, stock, debtors, cash, furniture, sundry creditors. All these items are the balance sheet items. Then other details: drawings, discount received, discount allowed, cash paid to creditors, then cash received from debtors, sundry expenses and capital as on 1st April 2017. This one, opening capital. Now, what are the items given here? Which are the accounts we need to prepare? Here, all the balance sheet items, stock, debtors, cash, furniture, creditors given. Then drawings, we need to adjust this one with along with the capital, opening capital, that is also given. Then discount received, discount allowed will come in which account? Discount received in the total creditors account, discount allowed in the debtors account. At the same time, this will appear again in the profit and loss account. Then cash paid to creditors, then cash received from debtors, then sundry expenses. So first we will prepare the debtors account. Here you must see the main items that we need to prepare trading account is what? Two, opening stock, that is available. Then two, purchases. You may know the items which are coming for the trading account: opening stock, then two, purchases less purchase returns, then two, direct expenses, buy sales, buy closing stock. Here opening stock, closing stock available, purchases and sales are not available. That is why we need to prepare the purchases, both credit purchases and credit sales. So that too we can prepare from the total debtors account and total creditors account. After calculating the purchases and sales, we will prepare the final accounts. Okay, now I will write it on the notebook. First write the numbers, number 17, illustration 17. Then first account, total debtors account. For that we need to write first the balance, opening balance. You can keep the textbook in front of you when I am explaining this, then you will understand. I cannot show both together. First opening balance. That is given in the tabular column. Second item, sundry debtors. That is opening balance 1/4/2017. That we have to write as balance brought down. Balance brought down 2,50,000. then next item, that closing item will be appearing on the credit side, last item. Then we will see what are the other items will be appearing in this total debtors account. Then cash, furniture, creditors, no. Then other details given, drawings will not come. Discount received, that will come in next account. Then discount allowed, 25,000 is given. That will be coming here. What is the discount allowed entry? Discount allowed account debtor to debtors account. So discount allowed account debtor. So by discount allowed. Discount allowed how much? 25,000. You have to write rupee symbol, particulars rupee symbol, you have to write, should not forget. The next one, cash paid to creditors, that will not come. Then cash received from debtors, it is related to debtors account, it will come. Where it will come? Here, by cash. Cash account debtor to debtors accounts. So by cash, 5,35,000. Then sundry expenses, capital. All the items we have referred. Now, the closing item we have to write. Closing balance. That is the second item in the tabular column. Sundry debtors, closing balance. So, how we will write? By balance carry down. Should not write there closing balance. You have to write balance carry down. 3,50,000. All the item we have entered. Now, we will balance it. So this side only more total. So you write, add and write. 3, 0, 5 plus 5, 10. Balance 1, 3, 3 plus 3, 6. Plus 5, 11. Balance 1, 6 plus 3, 9. So 9,10,000. Draw double line. Then here also draw one line and double line. Write the same, this total here. 9,10,000. Now we will balance. That will be the sales. To sales, which is sales, credit sales, then that is the balancing figure. Right, balancing figure. Now balance it and write 0, 0, 3, 0, 4, 0, 5, 5 plus 6, 10. Sorry, 5 plus 6, 11. Balance 1, 3. 3 plus 6, we will get 9. So 6,60,000 is the credit sales. Now we will prepare the next account, total creditors account. It is easy only if you listen. Often they ask one 5-mark problem. Total creditors account. Here, debtors account, debit balance, creditors account, credit balance. So by balance brought down. You have to see in the tabular column, sundry creditors, last item given, opening balance 1,50,000. So write that 1,50,000. Then the other details, drawings will not come, discount received is there. If opening balance is here, discount will be coming here. See here, discount allowed that side. So, 2, discount received. Discount received 20,000. Then, cash paid to creditors. Again, creditors account debtor to cash. That also debit side. Cash, 4,50,000. 4,50,000. Then, next item, cash received from debtors return. Sundry expenses will not come, opening capital. Now we should write the closing balance. Like here closing balance this side, here it is debit side. To balance carry down. That is given in the tabular column. Last item sundry creditors. Second column 1,75,000. Now total it. Debit side is more. So you have to write. Add and write. 5,000. Then 7 plus 7, 14, balance 1, 5 plus 1, 6. So 6,45,000. Write the same amount in the credit side also. 6,45,000. Now, buy what? Purchases. which purchases credit purchases. Credit purchases, that will be the balancing figure. If you listen every day, I am telling, so it will be by heart for you. So you have to balance and write. 0, 0, 3 zeros are there. 4th digit 5, write 5. 5th digit 5 there. We should get 4. So 5 plus 9, 14. Balance 1, 2. 2 plus 4, 6. So 4,95,000 is the credit purchases. Now we have to prepare the trading and profit and loss account. Profit and loss account for the year ended. They have asked in the question, prepare trading and profit and loss account for the year ended 31st March. You should write as it was given in the heading 2018. Now again we draw line. Again you have to draw particulars, amount. First item, just we will have a recollection. Trading account starts with opening stock. 2 opening stock, then purchases, then all direct expenses we will write. We will have a recollection of what are the direct expenses. First one, wages, then fuel, coal, lighting, then any manufacturing expenses, then a customs duty, octroi, dock charges. Many direct expenses are there. If any direct expenses are given, we have to write in the trading account. And on the credit side, we will write by sales, less sales returns, then by closing stock. That's all. Here, what are the items given? You have to enter. Here, stock is given. Opening stock. It is in the first item in the tabular column. 1 lakh. Then, 2 purchases. No purchase return, so you can write that one outer column. Okay, otherwise, we have to draw an inner column. It is in the accountancy notebook. 2 amount columns are there. That amount column, you can write if there is purchase returns or returns outwards. Here, no purchase returns, so we can write amount outside. Which purchases we have to write here? Only credit purchases given. If I think in the next problem they will give cash purchases, then we need to add cash purchases, cash, credit, add and write that one in the outer column. Now only one purchase is given, credit purchases, simply we can write purchases. 4,95,000. This amount is from the creditors account, this balancing figure. Then any direct expenses given? I think no direct expenses. Then by sales. Sales we have calculated in the debtors account, 6,60,000. 6,60,000. Then by closing stock. That is given in the tabular column. Closing stock, 50,000. 50,000. Now we will balance. This side only more. So write that one first. 7,10,000. Here also you write 7,10,000. Different amount is to gross profit. Gross profit carry down. We have to calculate now. 0, 0, 0, 3, 0. Here 5. We should get 0. So 5 plus 5, 10. We will get 0 there. Balance 1, 10. 10 we need to get 1. So 10 plus 1, 11. Balance 1, 2. 2 plus 4, 6. 6 plus 1, 6 plus 1 7. Okay, here I have written the other. You have to write straight to that one. Okay, now we will write. We have to carry. We have to write it here. Transfer that one to this profit and loss account. This is called a trading account. This account, profit and loss account, by gross profit brought down 1,15,000. Now, any expenses, indirect expenses. We have the expenses. I told you discount allowed, discount received, we have to write. So, discount allowed is a loss. So, we will write that one to discount allowed 25,000. Then, here by discount received. Discount received 20,000. Then sundry expenses, that is next item on the debit side. It is an indirect expenses. Sundry expenses 30,000, that we have to write. We have entered all the amount. So first write the total on the credit side. 1,35,000. Write the same amount here also. 1,35,000. Balance it. 2, 3, 5, 5 plus 8, 13. We got. So that is the net profit. 2 net profit. Bracket you have to write, transferred to capital account. I think you remember everything that we have studied last year. Transferred to capital account. Now we have prepared net profit. Prepared the trading and profit and loss account. Now we will prepare the balance sheet. Now we are going to prepare balance sheet as on 31st March 2018. Then right side assets rupees, liabilities rupees. So first we will write on the asset side. Okay, first given that stock. First you have to write the liquid assets. What is the first liquid asset? Cash at bank. Cash closing balance. Closing balance only you have to write. The second column, 40,000, that we have to write. Cash 40,000. Then sundry debtors. Sundry debtors. That also the closing balance. 3,50,000. Then one more current assets, closing stock. Closing stock 50,000. All the amount available in the second column, that is the closing balances. Okay, stock, debtors, cash we have written. Now the fixed asset, only one is given, furniture. So that we have to write 10,000. Now any other things will be coming, you have to see. Adjustment items, nothing. Opening capital, everything will be coming in the other accounts, not in the balance sheet. So okay, now we will write the liabilities. Now current liabilities. Any current liabilities given? Only sundry creditors. Sundry creditors. Sundry creditors closing balance 1,75,000, that you have to write. Then no other items given, only drawings there. Drawings is adjusted with the capital. So we will write the capital. Here the capital, which capital we have to write? The opening capital. 2,35,000 in the inner column. Okay. 2,35,000. Add net profit. Net profit that we have found out from the profit and loss account. Net profit we have calculated as 80,000. Net profit 80,000. So 5,000, 3 + 8 = 11, balance 1,3. Then from this amount we should deduct the drawings. Drawings 40,000 we have to deduct. Straight to 40,000 we should write 1, 2, 3, fourth digit 5. Then 1 - 4 we cannot deduct, so we should borrow. So you have to keep in your mind, don't cut and write there. Here 11 - 4, 7. Here what is available? 2. So 2,75,000. Now we will add and find out both the side, we should get the same balance. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 5 + 5, 0. Balance 1, 8 + 7, 15. Balance 1, 3 + 1, 4. We will check whether we get the same amount in the asset side also. 1, 2, 3, 4 also 0. 5th one, 4 + 5, 9, 9 + 5, 14 + 1, 5, 15. Balance 1, 4, 4,50,000. You have got the answer. So if you do, you will get the answer easily. But you have to be little careful. Now I will explain the next illustration. Illustration 18. Bharati does not maintain her books of accounts under double entry system. From the following details, prepare trading and profit and loss account for the year ending 31st March 2019 and a balance sheet as on that date. Here, cash book is given. Payments receipts. Payments, purchases, creditors, general expenses, wages, balance carried on. Then opening balance, sales, debtors. Here which is sales? Here cash sales. Here purchases, cash purchases. We need this one for preparing the trading account. Then general expenses will come in profit and loss account. Wages, trading account. Because it is a direct expenses, it will come under trading account. This one profit and loss account. This one cash balance, closing balance. This will come in the balance sheet. Then other particulars. Other information, stock of goods. In the previous problem, they have given this column first, all the balance sheet items. Stock of goods, that means opening stock. Opening stock, closing stock. Debtors, opening balance is given, closing balance is not given. We need to find out. So which account we have to prepare? Total debtors account we have to prepare. Then creditors both given. Machinery, opening and close, same only it is given. Again some additional information is given. Credit purchases, credit sales, opening capital, depreciate machinery by 10%. This machinery we need to calculate and we have to write in two places, one in the profit and loss account, another one we have to deduct from the closing machinery value. Okay, now we will start doing in the notebook. So first you have to write in the books of Bharati, that is the heading, Bharati does not maintain. So if we write this one here, again no need to write anywhere. Then to find out the closing sundry debtors, we have to prepare the total debtors account. So first opening balance is given, we will start with here particulars, rupees, everything we have to write. Okay, so first two balance brought down, 38,000. Then related to debtors account, what all the information available? Here From the cash book we can come. From the cash book, you see debit side they have given the third item, to debtor. So what is the entry debt, cash account debtor to debtor. So cash received from debtor. So by cash account 120,000. Then any other credit side nothing. Now the particulars column also we have written already. Again come to additional information. There credit sales given. Credit sales where we will write debtors account debtor to sales. Here we will write sales account bracket credit 140,000. In this problem we are going to calculate the balancing figure as the closing balance. So we will add and write 8,000 here 17. Here write the same amount here 178,000. Then the balance amount we have to write by balance carry down. That is the closing balance. Balancing figure. Write the amount. 0008 to there 5 + 2 = 7. That's all. One is there. So 58,000 we have got the closing debtors. Now we will prepare the trading and profit and loss account. Trading and profit and loss account. You have to write neatly for the year ending. For the year ending 31st March, that will be given in the beginning of the problem. 31st March 2019. Draw a single line. Now we will write. It starts with two opening stock. You have to search where opening stock is given. Stock of goods given. Two in the tabular column, second table. Stock of goods, the first one 40,000. That 40,000 we have to write here 40,000. Then two purchases. Here purchases in the cash book one purchases there. That is the cash purchases. So we have to write cash. These two we have to write in the inner column. Cash purchases 56,000. Then credit purchases given in the additional information 74,000. So add and write in the outer column 1, 2, 3, then 6 plus 4, 10, balance 1, 6 plus 7, 13. So 1,30,000 is the purchases. Then any direct expenses. When I explained the problem, I told you there is one expense on the payment side in the cash book, wages. That direct expenses will be coming in this trading account. Two wages, 10,000. Now no other item. We will come to the credit side by sales. Two sales available. So we will write cash sales. In the cash book, debit side given 1,60,000. Then credit sales in the additional information 1,40,000. Add and write in the outer column 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 + 4, 10, balance 1, 3. So 3 lakh is the sales. Now the last item, two item only on the credit side. First one sales and the next one is the closing stock. Closing stock is given in the other information, second table, first item. Closing stock 60,000. That 60,000 you can write. Now we will balance it. first which side more will be coming, you have to check. Here we have in the credit side only. Mostly we will get on the credit side only. Right. Here 1 lakh, here 3 lakh. So 3,60,000 is the total. Right, the same amount here also 3,60,000. Now the difference is the gross profit. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here 40,000. 4 plus 3, 7. 7 plus 1, 8. 8 plus 8, 16. Balance 1. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 plus 1, 3. So that is the gross profit. You have to write 2. Gross profit carry down. That's all. Now we will see the profit and loss account. We have to start, we have to write the heading and write the column, then we'll start the item. You have to start from the cash book. The asset side, cash in hand. In the cash book, balance carry down. That you have to write. Cash in hand. That is 1,42,000. Then other information, stock, closing stock. Closing stock 60,000. Then debtors, we calculated debtors. Closing balance we have calculated, that we need to write. Closing stock 60,000. Sorry, not closing stock, debtors. Debtors, closing debtors 58,000. Then debtors, then creditors will be coming here. Sundry creditors. Sundry creditors closing 52,000. Sorry students, we have to calculate the net profit. By mistake I have started the balance sheet. We will keep as it is. Now we will start the profit and loss account. We have to take the gross profit there. Gross profit carry down here. So gross profit brought down 1,80,000. Then along with the gross profit, any income given. No. Then the expenses we need to write. Expenses, payment side you have to check. Creditors, general expenses. That general expenses we can write. General expenses 24,000. Any other discount allowed, discount received, nothing given. So the last adjustment, additional information, depreciation. So we have to write 2 depreciation. Depreciation we need to calculate. That I will do with the pencil. Depreciation calculation. How to calculate, I am showing. Depreciation you have to calculate on machinery. What is the machinery amount? 1,70,000. Into how many percentage? 10%. 10 by 100. This zero and this zero we will cut. This zero and this zero we will cut. So what is the amount available? 17,000. That's amount you can write, 17,000. Now other items. So now we will write the total amount, 1,80,000 here. So 1,80,000, same amount here also. Now 2, net profit we have to calculate. Net profit transferred to capital account, we have to calculate the amount. 1, 0, 2, 3 zeros, then 7 plus 4, 11 plus 9, 20, 0. Balance 2, 4, 5, 5 plus 3, 8, 1. So 1,39,000 is the net profit. With this one, we will come to the balance sheet. I have explained cash in hand closing we have written, closing stock also we have written. Then the debtors that we have calculated, 58,000 balancing figure that we have written. Debtors. Now creditors we have written, closing amount 52,000. Now machinery will be the asset. Machinery we have to write inside 1,70,000 because this depreciation we need to deduct. So less depreciation 17,000. Draw a line, write straight to 17,000. 1, 2, 3, 10 minus 7, 3. Here 6 minus 1, 5. Here 1. So 1,53,000. That is the machinery value. Okay, machinery we have written. Then additional information, purchases, sales, then opening capital. Now we should write the capital. Capital 2,22,000. We need to add net profit along with the capital. No drawings given. So add net profit. We know with adjustment what we have to add, what we have to deduct. Add net profit, add interest on capital, less drawings, less interest on drawings. So here only one item, net profit. What is the net profit? 1,39,000. So straight to 1,39,000 we should write. 1, 2, 3, 9 plus 2, 11, balance 1, 3 plus 3, 6, balance, sorry, then 2 plus 1, 3. Now you add and write. Both the side we should get the same amount. 1, 2, 3, then 8 plus 2, 10, 10 plus 3, 13. 13 balance 1, 5, 5 plus 6, 11, 16, 16, 20, 1, balance 2, 2 plus 2, 4. Here 1, 0, 0, then 3, 11, 4. So 4,13,000 we have got. So the same exercise we have to do 17 and 18, and you do and send it. Otherwise, at least do and see. Okay, students? Thank you.